afternoon, Miss Fraskin.
Oh, good afternoon.
Into my office, Miss McNamara.
Where's the fire?
Just follow your master.
To the ends of the earth. Yes, sir.
Susie, I just had lunch at the Colonial.
The Colonial? Oh, I'll get your bicarbonate right away.
Susie.
Now, Mr. Sands, I'll bet you had that salmon, and you know what salmon does to you. It tries to swim right back upstream.
Susie, will you listen to me? I am trying to tell you something. I was eating lunch at the Colonial, and sitting right next to me was Bernard Hugo, the opera impresario.
No.
I could hear every word he was saying, and you know what? Hugo is going to produce on Broadway a spectacular production of Samson and Delilah in English.
No.
I heard him say that he was going to conduct a worldwide search for the leads.
But you're planning to save him the trouble.
You guessed it. Bernard Hugo presents Phyllis Gerard and Jeff Ritchie in Samson and Delilah.
I can see the beginning of a beautiful commission.
Oh, I'm not doing this for the money. Those kids deserve a break. Now, Jeff and Phyllis have well-known movie names. Imagine the furor when the public finds out those beautiful kids can really sing.
Well, Mr. Hugo better find it out first.
Hugo, Bernard, Hugo.
Would you like me to get it for you?
Susie, no, this is a really big deal. I've got to handle this personally from the word go.
Oh, certainly, sir. But Connie Dugan, Mr. Hugo's secretary, is a very good friend of mine, and I thought maybe...
Miss McNamara, when you are dealing with a giant like Bernard Hugo, you do not go around scratching on secretaries' doors. You must be a bold, ruthless. You must be a giant yourself.
I say...
Peter Sands calling Bernard Hugo, please. Peter Sands. Sands. S-A-N-D-S. That's right. Yes, I am an agent. I would like to speak... Yes, but... All right. Thank you very much.
Was the other giant out?
Who does he think he is? Mr. Hugo isn't seeing any Broadway or Hollywood agents. My clients aren't good enough for him. Just because Phyllis and Jeff have made a few bucks in movies, they're not good enough.
Well, I'm afraid Mr. Hugo is an intellectual and artistic snob. Small-town kids like Phyllis and Jeff wouldn't impress him.
Yes, but how can such a great producer be such a colossal idiot?
By working at it night and day.
Well, that's that. We can forget about it.
Not yet. Now, Connie, his secretary, tells me that it's Mrs. Hugo who makes the decisions.
Mrs. Hugo? That's ridiculous. Susie, have you ever met her?
No, but Connie tells me that...
Well, I have. She's a vague, twittering little cream puff whose only concern is that the cup match the saucer.
I'm merely trying to tell you what Connie tells me. She says that it's the missus who makes the decisions.
You girls and your flighty, romantic notion that behind every man is some noble, strong, long-suffering woman. Fiddle faddle.
Am I excused?
Yes.
Movie tonight.
Oh, that sounds great. What's playing?
Did you see Tarzan's Little Dividend?
No, let me see the bill of fare.
How about Son of the Glob?
Let me see. The Bijou is playing 10 Crazy Killers.
Oh, I don't think I feel like a musical. Isn't there anything exciting?
Stacy Diggs' column.
That sounds good.
Impresario Bernard Hugo is miffed, and we don't blame him.
Good beginning.
For the past six seasons, he has headed the Opera Association's annual dinner, but this year, because of the preparations for Samson and Delilah, he told the association they would have to find someone to take his place. So far, not one of the so-called opera lovers has volunteered for the responsible position.
Susie, you ruined the whole movie by telling me the plot.
The only thing I'm going to see is Connie Dugan.
Who? What? What for?
To help Phyllis and Jeff in the only way I know, by scratching on a fellow secretary's door.
I think I'll go see Son of the Glob.
Oh.
dear, we won't be casting until next month.
Oh, but I'm looking for Connie Dugan.
Didn't you hear? Our Connie ran off and got married. I'm Mrs. Hugo. I'm just sort of keeping the office open until I can find the right secretary for my husband.
A girl who's efficient, capable, and
not very good looking.
Well, how do you do, Mrs. Hugo? I'm Susan McNamara. Connie spoke of you often. Isn't it nice about her getting married?
Oh, yes. You're a friend of Connie's?
Well, yes, sort of. We took a shorthand refresher course together.
Oh, how nice. You will have to excuse me, Miss McNamara. There's so much work to be done. We're going into production, you know.
Yes, I read something about it. Well, I guess I'll just have to take another turn around the park. I simply cannot go back to my office when my boss, Mr. Sands, Peter Sands of International Artists, hasn't anything to keep himself busy. He just drives everybody absolutely crazy.
Mr. Hugo is much the same. But his problem right now is there just aren't enough hours in the day for him to attend to everything.
It was too bad we couldn't join forces. Well, I suppose I should go back and play Scrabble with Mr. Sands. He gets so nervous when he just sits there listening to those scratchy opera records. That's what I'll do. I'll stop by and buy him some new opera records to brighten up his day. Well, goodbye.
Records? Is Mr. Sands a music lover?
Oh, Mrs. Hugo, he sleeps, drinks, eats, and dreams music.
Miss McNamara, I've just had an idea.
Oh, is that so?
You've heard of the Opera Association, haven't you?
Oh, yes, I've read something about it. It seems to me you're having difficulty in finding someone taking over the chairmanship.
Difficulty? It's been impossible. Miss McNamara, do you think Mr. Sands would...
Would what?
Oh, no, I couldn't.
Yes, you could.
Why not? You said Mr. Sands loves music.
Oh, he's mad about it.
Oh, but I couldn't. He wouldn't. But anyone who loves opera would be glad to give of his time. Oh, but it would be too presumptuous of me.
Now, Mrs. Hugo, Mr. Sands would be honored to take over the chairmanship of the opera's dinner.
Do you really think so?
I know so.
Would you ask him for us, Miss McNamara?
Well, dear, don't you think it would be better if you wrote a letter? He'd like that. You know how men are.
Yes, my dear. And so do you.
The Opera Association. You can tell them no.
No?
That's right, no.
Oh, but Mr. Sands, they want you to be chairman of the Opera Association dinner.
Let them get someone else to serve their soup.
Oh, well, that's a shame. There'll be so many important people there. Mr. and Mrs. Hamilton Sirrah, the Fraser Sims, Mr. and Mrs. Bernard Hugo.
Mrs. Bernard Hugo? Mr. and Mrs. Bernard Hugo. Susie, I have had a change of heart. You may tell them I accept.
You accept, yes, sir.
You see, Susie, if I accept this position, I will be put in close contact with the very elusive Mr. Hugo.
And the closer I get to Mr. Hugo, the closer Phyllis and Jeff get to Samson and Delilah.
Oh, Mr. Sands, you just go too fast for me. Oh, good morning, Mrs. Hugo.
Miss McNamara, good morning, good morning, good morning. Such a heavenly odor. I love lilacs.
Why, what an unusual coincidence. So does Mr. Sands.
How nice.
He absolutely wallows in lilacs.
Well, I'll have to invite him over for a lilac dinner sometime.
Lilac dinner?
Oh, you have to develop a taste for it, just like you do for baked dandelions. You sit down.
Yes, well, thank you very much.
I love exotic dishes. It's really a lost art, you know.
But that's what I came to see you about. Dinner.
Dinner?
Yes. Well, now that Mr. Sands is chairman of the opera dinner, he would like to discuss the menu with you.
Oh, that dinner. Well, there goes my I died again.
Well, I don't understand.
My dear, I'm always fighting the battle of the bulge. I starve myself to lose weight, take steam baths, look for crooked scales. I even take long walks between restaurants. I lose a few pounds, and then along comes one of these dinners, and the balloon goes up again.
I know exactly what you mean.
You don't know what I go through. I even went to a masseur. Why, the man was a sadist. He beat me black and blue. I'm a great believer in exercise for men and light meals for ladies.
Exercise for men and light meals for ladies?
That's my sentiment.
But, Mrs. Hugo, don't you think planning a meal for ravenous males and diet-conscious females presents quite a problem?
Nonsense, my dear. Is there a law against two menus?
Two menus?
I always say that for everything in life, there should be a choice.
Two menus? Why, Mrs. Hugo, that's absolutely marvelous. Well, I must get back to Mr. Sears. We've got lots to keep us busy with this dinner. Oh, and Mrs. Hugo, Mr. Sands would like to discuss with someone his duties as chairman.
Well, of course he would. Now, let me see. What has Bernard for the next?
Well, it doesn't necessarily have to be Mr. Hugo. It could be Mrs. Hugo.
Me?
Yes, I'm sure you would be a great help to Mr. Sands.
Do you really?
Yes. I'm sure that Mr. Sands would enjoy meeting the charming, attractive lady of the household.
Miss McNamara, you know your women, too.
And so do you, Mrs.
Mrs. Hugo? What do I want with Mrs. Hugo? I took this job to get in with Mr. Hugo so I could get an audition for Jeff and Phyllis.
Yes, but Mrs. Sands, you really have to see her. After all, she is the great man's wife, and I'll see that she only stays a few minutes.
Well, all right. What are you doing with it?
This is lilac. Hello. Oh.
Well, what are you spraying me with it for?
Well, it's...
Susie, there's a man out there with some lilacs.
Oh, fine. Spray some more.
Oh, spray? All right.
Stop that!
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Sands. Excuse me. I was just doing what Susie told me to. I'm sorry.
Susie, the lilacs, the spray, I want an answer.
Oh, Mr. Sands, I thought you knew.
Knew what?
Phone call for you, Susie.
I'm ready.
All right.
Now, listen carefully, Phyllis. You and Jeff get here in a half an hour. I'll have everything all set. Uh-huh. And it'll be late. Okay. Bye. Get a vase, fill it with water, and bring it into Mr. Sands.
Susie, I demand an answer. What is the reason for all this disorganized confusion?
Yes, of course, Mr. Sands.
Here's the vase, Susie.
Oh, yes. Put these in, and I'll get rid of this.
All right.
No, you don't. No one gets out of here until I get an explanation.
But, Mr. Sands, I'm just following through with what you always say.
What I always say?
Yes. That it's good business to be nice to the wife of the client you're after.
Oh? Well, is that what I always say?
Mm-hmm. Especially when the wife is mad about the scent of lilacs, hence the cologne and the lilacs.
Naturally. Bye. Back to your post.
It was so exciting for a while, wasn't it?
It's always good business to be nice to the wife of the client you're after. Very wise. Susie, sit down. I have some dictation for him.
Hey.
The menu for the Opera Association dinner by Peter Sands. Stuffed eggs, stuffed celery, stuffed artichokes.
Stuffed people.
Cream spinach, cheese blintzes, hush puppies.
Hush puppies?
Love them. Ravioli. Au gratin potatoes, stuffed potatoes, hash brown potatoes.
You forgot candied potatoes.
Oh, I don't want to go overboard on the starch. Black bottom cream chiffon pie, a la mode.
No meat?
Steak and more steak. Make your mouth water.
Put on a couple of pounds just writing it down.
You don't think it's too much, do you?
Too much? Well, not for a husky man like you, Mr. Sands, but how about those diet-conscious females?
No stuffed potatoes.
Bare boating.
No bleaching?
Not a teensy, Blancy.
And black bottom cream chiffon pie puts on too much weight.
Well, I'll be darned if I'm going to sit there and pick at some no-calorie meal.
Well, I don't blame you, but still, it does seem a shame only the gentleman could enjoy the dinner.
Well, what am I supposed to do? I can't have two menus.
Two menus? But it's a marvelous idea.
What?
Well, a hearty meal for the gentlemen and a low-calorie meal for the women.
Two menus? Two menus. Two menus. Fabulous.
Mrs. Bernard Hugo to see Mr. Sam.
Just a moment.
Send her in.
Come in, Mrs. Hugo. Mrs. Hugo, may I present Mr. Sam?
We've met before. How are you, Mr. Sam?
Nice to see you.
Lilac cologne. How positively reeky. Lilacs. Oh, my favorite flower.
Then you shall take them with you.
Oh, Mr. Sands, how gallant.
Won't you sit down?
Well, I know you two have lots to talk about, so I'm sure I'm excused.
Hi.
Hi, dear.
Hi.
I understand she's here.
Yes, everything's perfect so far.
I better warm up my voice.
Well, no, that won't be necessary. I just want you to meet her.
Oh, we're not going to sing for her today.
Well, no, not today. But if I know Mrs. Hugo, not only will you sing for her, but Mr. Hugo as well.
Bernard Hugo.
Uh-huh. Now, you kids wait outside. I have to break up the love affair. Bye. I'll call you. Me. It's time for your exercise, Mr. Sands.
Exercise?
Don't let me detain you, Mr. Sands. I'm all for exercise. For men.
For an exceptional man, Miss McNamara. Do you know what he's planning for the Opera Association dinner?
Two menus. Isn't that an original idea? Well, goodbye, Mr. Sands.
Must you go so soon, Mrs. Hugo?
Oh, I've taken enough of your time. Thank you for the lilacs. My favorite, you know.
Yes, I know.
Your time on a shorthand refresher course.
Well, Mr. Sands does dictate rather rapidly.
I never heard such a sales talk. If Mr. Sands were a car, I'd be parking him in my garage right now.
Hugo, whatever do you mean?
Now, I think it's about time you called me Dolly, and I called you Susie, and we started working together.
Dolly?
Susie? Now, what is it you're selling?
1 minute. Kids. Mrs. Hugo, may I present Phyllis Gerard and Jeff Ritchie.
How do you do?
My, aren't they?
Hello.
Pretty. Her, too.
And they sing even better than they look. They've really got it.
And if they didn't have it, you'd get it for them.
Mrs. Hugo. Well, that's all for now, kids. And don't forget the audition tomorrow at 2 o'clock.
We won't. Thank you, Susie. Nice meeting you, Mrs. Hugo.
Thank you.
Same here, Mrs. Hugo. So long, Susie.
Bye.
Now, what's the next move?
Well, to get Mr. Hugo to listen to them sing.
Exactly. And how Bernard hates auditions.
Well, Phyllis and Jeff are giving an audition for the Golden Bread TV hour tomorrow at 2 o'clock in Mr. Sands' office.
Oh, now this is convenient. Tomorrow at 1, Bernard is taking me to lunch at a darling little place around the corner from here.
Good. Then you could sort of drop up here after 2, and the audition would already have started.
We'll sit in your office, and while we sit, the pretty music from the next office
will be brought through the half-open door through courtesy of Susan McNamara, door lever open.
If your boss doesn't make a strike with this setup,
we'll set him up again.
A little after two. Incidentally, Susie, if you ever decide to go crooked, I'll join your gang.
Hugo. Well, come along, dear.
Bye-bye.
I made quite a hit.
Oh, you certainly did. And everything is just working beautifully. I made an appointment for Mr. Hugo to be here tomorrow at 2 o'clock.
Susie, 2 o'clock tomorrow is the Golden Bread TV audition.
Oh, what a terrible mistake.
I can't understand these things. I can't understand how... Wait a minute.
Wait a minute. This is wonderful.
What is it?
Now, you very nicely tell the Hugos that I'll be tied up for a few moments. You ask him to sit down in your office. This is great. Then, while Phyllis and Jeff sing, I will leave the door open to my office. See,
they'll be auditioning not only for the Golden Bread TV hour, but for the great Bernard Hugo as well.
Oh, Sand, all this maneuvering just makes my head spin.
My, what lovely voices. So rich and strong, Bernard.
Very nice.
And so attractive.
I'm sorry, young lady, but tell Mr. Sands that it's almost impossible for me to wait any longer.
Oh, Miss McNamara, do you suppose Mr. Sands could pop in for just a tiny second? I want Bernard to shake the hand of the man who has given us the double menu.
Yes.
And ask the young people to pop in, too. I'd like to thank them for their concert.
Thank you.
Just wait till you see how pretty the little soprano is.
I'm terribly sorry to have kept you waiting.
It was a pleasure, Mr. Sands, wasn't it, Bernard?
Sands, I'm Bernard Hugo. Understand you're doing a crackerjack job on the opera dinner.
Thank you.
A very worthwhile cause. Keep up the good work. Very nice indeed. Thank you.
Oh, Mr. Hugo, may I present Miss Phyllis Gerard, Mr. Jeff Ritchie?
How do you do?
How do you do? You probably remember them. They both have a few Broadway shows under their belts and several movies.
Movies? I don't have time to watch them. I'll wait for you outside, Mrs. Hugo.
Coming, Bernard. Such pretty voices to come out of such pretty people.
Thank you.
They look just like Samson and Delilah to me. Bye.
Bye.
Well, there's still the Golden Bread TV hour.
Yeah.
You kids go ahead and wait in the office. I'll be in a minute.
Mr. Sands, I wouldn't be in too big a hurry to sign that bread contract.
Why?
Well, I've just got a funny little hunch about something.
Miss McNamara, it occurs to me you're taking this very lightly. Don't you care about those kids? Don't you care about the agency? Don't you care?
Sands, don't make any commitments for that boy and girl. Maybe I can use them in my show. It came to me in the elevator that maybe, with a lot of patience, I can mold a Samson and Delilah out of them.
Oh, I think that's such interesting casting, Bernard. Don't you, Miss McNamara?
Well, nothing the great Hugo does would surprise me.
Thank you, Miss McNamara. Call me. Mrs. Hugo, enough of this dilly-dallying. There's work to be done.
Well, Susie, head's still spinning.
Oh, Mr. Sands, it was wonderful, absolutely wonderful, the way you handled him.
That old buzzard doesn't fool me for a minute. If he thinks that by playing that cold shoulder routine, he can get Jeff and Phyllis to work for less, he's got another think coming. I could tell it from his eyes. In the very beginning, he was crazy about those kids.
Yes, well, Mrs. Hugo liked them, too.
Susie, still looking for the woman behind the man. Who's behind me? You?
You said it. I didn't.